kids, welcome to our online classes. For today's class, we will discuss a very new thing. I hope it's not new, but as we didn't have any chapter like that earlier, so I think that's this is quite not so similar with the earlier topics. Okay, so today's class will be about auxiliary verbs, of course, but it's about auxiliary verb. Which type of auxiliary verbs? It's about a present perfect auxiliary verbs like have and has. Okay, so today we will learn where to use have and where to use has. That means you have to learn the use of have and has. So it's nothing actually serious one. It's nothing that type of tough one. I hope you can make it out, as I know you are very good in grammar. So I think it would not be so difficult for you to capture this class. Okay, so just you need to have a little bit more concentration. I hope you will make it out surely. Okay, so have that confidence and trust that I will do it. So with that hope, please let us go through the class. Okay, first of all, this item, that means item number 31 and 32, collaboratively these items are actually given in a one graph. So in this chapter you will have the use of have and has. So where to use have and where not to use have, where to put has and where not to put has. This is the main thing of our, this is the main thing and of course at the same time the main theme of our this class. Okay, let me tell you. Have basically is a kind of auxiliary verb that is used for present perfect tense, but sometimes in the simple present tense also we can use have. But after what we will use have? After the first person, like I, we. As we know that who are the first person? Me is the first person. That means I am the first person. Don't you put yourself always at the first rank? Of course, whenever you are asked for anything, whenever you have to rank something, what should we do? We always think for ourselves. That means you think for your own self. So this is I. I am the best. I am always the first. So that's why I is the first person. So related to the I, everything, that every pronoun is what? First person. Like I, me, our, us, we, etc. So have is used for that first person. After the first person, the have is used. Okay, like I have, we have, that's it. Then see, second person. With second person we can also use have, like you have. You is the second person, you have. Okay, sometimes for plural numbers, not sometimes, every for always after the plural person, plural numbers, you have to put have. Like they, this, these, this, not this, these, this, those, they. Okay, so here basically in the given examples you will have some of the specific pronouns like I, we, some of the names, I mean any names. So you have to put have or has, and now you have to think about it, that where to use have and where to use has. So basically have will be used, I'm just giving you the clear view that remember have will be used after I, we, you and some of the plural numbers. Okay, clear? Then has will be used after third person singular number. Who are the third person singular numbers? Like it, this, she, he. Okay, and along with that, every name is a third person singular number, like Todit, Ortho, Zunayet, Khatiman, Khatijoy, any name, Tiana or Priyanka means, Opu means, Nilufar means, every name is third person singular number. I also told you earlier in the class that every number that you hear, that you take the name, everything that is singular number. I mean, every name is third person singular number. So after every name, you will have to put have or has. Of course, has. Because has is been used after third person singular number. Has will be used after third person singular number. I repeat, has will be used after third person singular number. Now, who are the third person singular numbers? Any name. Along with it, these, that, and every name is a third person singular number. After every name we will put has, after every it we will put has, after every this we will put has, after every that we will put has, and rest of the items will be for have, like I, we, you, I, we, you, they, I, we, you, they. Just try to recall the name, recall the pronouns I, we, you, they have, I, we, you, they have. That's it, okay? And every third person singular number, after every third person singular number, there will be a his, okay? So now please have a look on the board. See, have is for first person, like I, we, and for second person, you, I, we, have. I, we, you, for have, and they, I, we, they, you, have, I, we, they, you, okay, I, we, they, you, is for have, that means after I, we will put have, after we will put have, after you, we will put have, after the they, of course, there will be a have, okay, now, after, where to use has, after third person singular number. After she, you have to put his. After he, you have to put his. After it, you have to put his. After this, you have to put his. After that, you have to put his. Okay? So, I, we, you, they, it is for have. She, he, she, it, this, that, for his. Okay? And any name. That means any name. Like Kamal, Jamal, Rohim, Todit, Ortho, Karuno. After Tiana, Yosha, after every name, you have to put his. So I hope you are now, you have that clear idea about where to use have and where to use has. Now please go through the page, your page. It is item number 31 and 32 from Active English Workbook. See, Active English Workbook, look at the board please. Active English Workbook, item number 31 and 32. Write have or has. So you have to put have or has in the specific blanks. Okay. So here some of the blanks are given. See, number one, I dash a book. What should I use? Have or has? As I told you that after I, what should I put? Have. So I have to put here have. After you, what should I use? After you, you is for have. So, you dash a blue shirt. That means you have a blue shirt. We. After we, what should we put? See, we is for have. So, we have to put a have. We have rulers. Then they. After they, what should we put? Remember, I, we, you, they. I, we, you, they is for have. I, we, you, they is for have. I again repeat. I, we, you, they for have. So as it is they. So they is for have. So they have pen or pencils. See, and now you can ask me that, Miss, you told that for first person and second person we use have. But they, is it first person or second person? No, it's though it's not neither of them, but it's a plural number. They is used for plural ones. Isn't it? Is they a singular number? No. I told you that for plural number we will use have. Has will be used for singular number. Which kind of singular number? Third person singular number. Okay. So as they is the plural number, so after plural number we have to use have. Now coming to the next one, number 5 is Mira Jess. Mira Jess a doll. Mira. See, I told you that any name is third person singular number. So after any name, that means after any third person singular number, you have to put his. So Mira has a doll. Mira has a doll. Okay, now 6. She. She, is it a third person or first person or second person? She is third person. So after third person singular number, she means here only one person is indicated. So for only one person, we consider it as third person singular number. So after third person singular number, what should we use? We use have or has. Of course has. So you have to put here has. She has a white dress. Number 7. I would like to ask you to have your Active English Workbook with you along with your pencils so that you can took it down. You can note it down and you will make sure that Miss will check it out. So number 7 is Asim dash a kite. Asim. See, Is Asim a name of someone? Of course, Asim is the name of boy. And Asim means it is singular number. That means third person singular number. So of course, after third person singular number, we have to put his or have. See the tips just that done beside the exercises. Here has is for any name. Any name means see Asim is of course the name of boy. So after Asim, we can put his. Asim has a kite. The number 8, Asim and Miran dress red shirts. Asim and Miran. Now here say you be concentrated on this. We need to have little bit more attention. See, Asim and Miran, two are the names here. So both are third person singular number. So logically we have to put his, isn't it? Of course. But see, Asim and Miran, when we are talking about two person, is it a singular? If you are talking about two persons, will it be a singular noun or plural noun? Of course, more than one is plural number. And here not only Asim but also Miran is here. So Asim and Miran collaboratively, they are two persons. So in total, if there are two persons, for two persons we will consider it as plural number. And if it is plural number, see on the black or on the white board, if it is plural number, I again show you, if it is plural number, you have to put have. It is plural number, you have to put have. Miran and Asim, they are now two. And if it is more than one, then it becomes plural number. And if it is plural number, then of course you have to put have. As Asim and Miran are two and they are now considered as plural number, so we have to put here have. Asim and Miran have red shirts. Okay. Now number 9, the children. See, children means so many childs at a time, I mean together, okay? So many kids are together, they are called children. Child is singular number and the plural of child is children. So for this plural number, what should we put? Have or has? Remember, for plural number, look at the box that given beside the examples. Look at the box. For plural number, we will use have. As the children is plural number, so we will put have. The children have chairs and desks. What if their only child, if it is child, then we could use has, because child is a third person singular number. It is about only one child. If it is about one, then we will put has. But if it is about more than one, we will put surely have. Okay. Now number 10, the cow dash tail. The cow dash tail. See the cow. The cow, that means it is indicating only a cow. Okay, so if it is, it's not cows. If there's a s, it would be plural number. So if it would be a plural number, we could use have. But it's only cow, a cow. Okay, so there's no s. So we will consider it as a singular number. So after the singular number, what should we put? We will put has. Okay, so the cow has tail. Is it clear? I hope it is clear with you. Now coming to the number 11, he dash a pen and she dash a pen. It is the easiest one of all these exercises. See, he and she. He, she, it, this, that, and any name is for his. He, she. Is there any he? Of course. Beside the his, I have put he. So logically, you can understand that for he, you can put his. So as here is he, after he, I have to put his. And after she, again after she, you have to put his. So it becomes he has a pen and she has a pen. Okay? It's clear. He, she, this, that, and any name is for his. I, we, you, they is for have. And any plural number is for him. Hip. Now number 12, we dash books on our desk. We, I, we, you, they for have. I, we, you, they for have. So here for we, you have to put have. We have books on our desks. Okay. Now number 13, you, I, we, you, they. So I, we, you, they for have. If it is for have, then you, after you, what should we put? We have to put a have. You have
pictures in your classroom. You have pictures in your classroom. I dash black here. I, it's a first person. First person, singular number. So, after the first person, definitely there will be have. I have black hair. So, all that you have to do is, you have to remember what is the subject. If the subject I, you, we, they, then after the subject, you have to put have. But if the subject is any name, if the subject is she, he, it, this, that, and any name, and of course singular one, then you have to put his. If there are more than two or more than one, you have to put also have. So these all are in this way. Again, let us go through. I have a book, you have a blue shirt, we have rulers, they have pen or pencils, Mira has a doll, she has a white dress, Asim has a kite, Asim and Miran have red shirts, the children have chairs and discs, the cow has tail, she has a pen and she has a pen. We have books on our desks. You have pictures in your classroom. I have black hair. Okay. So, in this way, I hope you can make it out. So, for I, we, you, they, we will put have. He, she, it, this, that, and any name will be third person singular number. And after third person singular number, we will put has. Okay. So, remember just two hints and two things. I hope you will make it out surely. I have that trust on you. So please fill this blanks into your book and submit it. So we will meet very soon. Till then, stay well and stay safe.